These are the ruins. The broken alluvian should be around here. You don't seem to be that pleased to be out of the tower, Finn. I thought most mages wanted to be free.
Why? Just to be outside? Do you see this splotch here on my robe? That's mud. There's no mud in the tower. I miss being cozy and dry. Remind me not to step in that.
Right.
People were very sick before they died. Itabellus, Lethalin.
You don't think it's contagious, do you?
As you wish. Let's get started.
Alluvians. It's magnificent. And broken. Mostly broken. We have the shard of the Alluvian, but we still need the lights of Arlathan. We should head to Kadash Tide when you're ready to leave. I'm not sure I like the deep roads. Fewer darkspawn than expected, but it feels like we're being watched. Wait, why did we stop? Is this Kadash Tide? Right, so I've been going through my old notes. And I came across this footnote. Apparently, the elves would magically conceal relics of great significance, thus shielding them from unworthy eyes. And given what the Tevinters did, I'd say they count as unworthy.
You don't say.
I hate to say it, but yes. We wouldn't be able to see the lights of Arlathan if they were right under our noses. If the elves concealed the relics with magic, only the blood of their kin will reveal them. Ariane, we need your blood.
Excuse me?
Just a few drops, that's it. Blood doesn't power the spell, it's just a component. It's certainly a gray area, so let's just keep this between the three of us, shall we? Four of us. You share the same blood as the Arlathan elves, so you're the only one this enchantment might recognize.
Fine. Just because hearing that gets me all tingly. A few drops.
I'll be gentle. Ah! My spell will reveal vortices of magic. Standing in them should allow us to see the energy being drawn to the relics, which will lead us to them. Once we reach the influence of the lights of Arlathan, Ariane's blood will unveil them. But we have to be close.
Right.
Creatures. interesting. This carving over here is an old dwarven dialect. If you find more writing like this, I could probably translate it. Remind me not to step in that. Magical vortex. We can use it to reveal the energy flowing towards the lights of Alathin. Do you see it? Can you follow the path? I always thought dwarves must be dull without magic. But this place is amazing.
Should be easy enough. Let's get started.
Kadash dwarves didn't even know they once had elves living here. Wouldn't this be remarkable enough to record in the memories? I think something's here. Realize the statue was capable of being literal. I should study dwarven history when I return. Oh, what's
that? Creatures.
Pay attention to where they're going. something here. Magic? Special fuel? Perhaps the design of the sconces? Hey, wait up! Let's see.
I see.
Motion senses tingling. Should be easy enough.
Oh!
I wonder if the relics. That's disappointing. So you've never been outdoors? Till now?
I have been. I just don't care much for it. We had to do stretching exercises. I got sweaty. There was dirt. During my apprenticeship, they thought getting fresh air and exercise at least once a week would do us good.
Fresh air and sunlight is good for you.
You know what feels fresh air in the summer? Mosquitoes. Hungry for sweet, untested mage flesh.
Well, when you put it that way...
Luckily, it didn't last long. One day, an apprentice made a break for it. Jumped off the dock and started swimming for the shore. The Templars couldn't jump in after him. Not with the armor on. Finally found him a week later. We stopped having to go out after that. That mage, Anders, never stopped trying to escape, though. Haven't heard from him since his last attempt.
It's like standing in a field of stars. And they're showing us the way. Finn!
Sorry. Over here, perhaps.
Let's get started.
Dude.
true then. A small group of elves took refuge here. It's like playing hide and seek, isn't it? Sure. Oh well.
Kalsharok destroyed Cad-Halash. The dwarves slaughtered their own because they feared the Tevinter Imperium. Despicable. If you hate the outside so much, why come with us?
Couldn't pass up a chance to learn more about the ancient elves and the mirrors. Besides, the company is good.
Thanks.
I meant the dog.
This should be easy enough.
Come to me, oh sweet.
Thank you.
have the Shard of the Illuvian and the Lights of Alathen. Now all we have to do is scry for an unbroken mirror. I saw a suitable place for the ritual not too far from here.
Prepare yourself. The ritual may attract unwanted attention. You'll have to protect me.
Right.
Get ready! In my robe.
What happened to Ariane? Give us your blood. Who cares if it hurts?
It's my blood. That's different. I've pinpointed another Illuvian. It's in the Dragonbone Wastes. The Tevintus probably moved it there to see if the ancient Dragonbones could enhance the Illuvian's power. It might be hidden. Or only appear to those who know its location. We examine the mirror. It might give clues to what Morrigan's doing. If she's looking for the Illuvians as well, she might even be there. Shall we?
Let me just get this again. Your name is Florian Phineas...
Horatio Aldebrandt. Esquire. Can't forget the Esquire. Father insisted.
Did your parents hate you?
No. They adore me. In fact, I'm sure my name is a result of overwhelming love replacing good sense.
Let's get started.
We're here. Keep your eyes open for dragons and mirrors.
Dragon worshiper before? Not much for small talk, are they?
Why would anyone worship a dragon?
Dragons are big, powerful, and they breathe fire! Some people are easily impressed.
Perhaps the dog needs some privacy?
Let's get started. As you wish.
Is that
a Vartaril? It can't be. They're only legends. It is said they were rock and tree, wind and rain, given form and breath by the elven gods to protect their people.
To protect their people? Then why does it look like it's going to eat you?
This should be easy enough.
And it's glowing. We should...
I think she's expecting you. Ask her about our book.
No further, please. One more step and I leave. For good this time. I assume you know what this is. I have gone to great lengths to find and activate this portal. Give me reason and I use it, and you will not be able to follow. To another place. Beyond this world and beyond the Fade. But this portal can only be used once more. Achieving even this much was difficult. I remained to see if it was truly you. I had to know. Tell me, why did you come? And you once argued with me that love is not weakness. I will never understand you, and you will never understand me. I would not even know where to begin explaining. He is safe, and beyond your reach. All you need to know is that the child is an innocent. He knows nothing of the destiny that lies before him. Because the child is yours, I understand. I will not share my plan with you. I dare not. If your trust is insufficient, then your anger will have to do. I did not betray you. I left, just as I said I would. And what choice did I have? How was I to know that the battle with the Archdemon would come so soon? And when it did, I came to you. I needed you, yes, but I also did not want to see you die. And here you stand, alive. So do not speak to me of betrayal. My plan is to leave and prepare the child for what is to come. Such preparation requires time and power. I must have both if I am to be successful. More than this, I dare not say, even to you. Then allow me to provide you a warning. 'Tis Flemeth you should beware of, not me. Hunt her if you hunt anyone. My mother has tricked her way past death and more. She is no more finished than I am. I thought I knew what Flemeth planned. I thought what she craved was immortality, and yet I was wrong. So very wrong. She is no blood mage, no abomination. She is not even truly human. The ritual was but a means to an end, a herald for what is to come. Change is coming to the world. Many fear change and will fight it with every fiber of their being. But sometimes, change is what they need most. Sometimes, change is what sets them free. What I want is unimportant now. I cannot tarry longer. The time has come for me to go. You cannot know what you ask. 'Twould be better if you stayed. For you. For us both. Then come, my love. We will face the future together.